And I'm working in Bitticino in charge of the export of Bitticino brand. This is the second webinar of three webinars where we talk about the, sorry that I have to do the settings here, just a second. Because I want to have the, okay. And okay. You should see me. Okay. Perfect. So okay. And now I see you in second. So this is the second webinar of a series of three. We talked last Tuesday about the tour system, and the next Tuesday, 28th of March, we'll talk about Sphera external panel. We have a direct link here that is quite complicated, but from this link, you can see the last webinar. Okay, now, the agenda of today is quite simple and fully concentrated over the video configurator we have over our website. So we will talk how to prepare a video queue, that is a very easy step, and the web configurator, what it gives you. I put in every slide the direct link in blue of the video configurator, so you can save it and use it directly. Topics is how to make a quotation, or let's say how to have the list of the items that you need. Because the Dorian system is composed by, it's a system, so it's composed by different product, and we need a list. We have two tools. Today we are talking about the video configurator, the one on left hand side, and we have for, let's say, advanced solution or complicated project, if you think a compound of towers with in every tower 20 flats and all connected together, we have to use a specific software that is UDiagram, that is downloadable from the Bitticino website. We will talk a dedicated webinar for this, but the today topics is the video configurator. So an easy way for, let's say, almost everyone to have, to prepare a quotation. How to use it? So let's say before order the standard solution, there was the contractor that visit the retail and ask an offer or a quotation for a normal project. Normal project, the average is 10 flats with one external panel. The wholesaler, if it doesn't have a person that is trained and is able to use the software across to the distributor, and distributor as well should be organized, of course, but sometimes not, and is asked, asking us to have a quotation. So you see that it's becoming quite slow, this process. Could be in a super easy way that in one day he has a quotation, but can be as well 3-4 days. So today, what we do? Retailer clerk or the contractors can do by themselves the list. And if there is an update or we have a new product, as soon as the new product is on the market, we update inside the web page. So you can find it there and you don't have to go and select from the catalog the product and all the details. The web configurator is divided in four easy steps. We have general information, customized entrance panel. We always start from the entrance panel. And we have to select the internal units. And then we get the summary, so the list of the items. Before to start a simulation with the web configurator, I would like to say we have to keep in mind what we need. So make two questions more to the customer. It solve misunderstanding, wrong calculation, a wrong list. Maybe you did understood and you make a list of items that is too expensive because it was not what is in need, or you give the wrong product. So, first, make it clear. How many external panel do you need? How many entrance do you have? What do you need over the external panel? Over the external panel, you need the push button, or you need the digital code? Do you need as well a keyboard to open the gate? So these are the questions that you should do. Then how many flats there are inside the building? Quite easy. So is the things I said, it's very easy step. And a tip that I always recommend, that is the one I'm using, I do a simple sketch with pen and paper, even on the phone. I draw a simple external panel. I draw the camera if it's video. I put the number of push buttons that I need, that they must correspond to the apartment we have. So in this case, we have 4 push buttons and 4 internal units. In each apartment, there is 1 internal unit. And then remember to ask if it's hands-free, handset, if there is an additional handset, maybe they put in the bedroom an additional one. When you have this drawing, let's say that 80% of the work is done. So at that point, I show you over the PowerPoint first, but then we go into reality. You go to vticino.com. You can go to software and app as well. We have 2 ways to enter, that is when you see the internal the door entry system, it's fine. So or either here or here. Or as I say before, we can go from software and app. Then when you arrive here, you have door entry system configurator for villa and condominium. The direct link is vdeconfigurator.vticino.com. Let's go to see how it works. Okay. So I was showing you. So this is the vticino.com. If you go, I use the process I always do. I go vticino.com because it's super easy to remember. So maybe you have in your favorite. Just go here. You have these 2 options. We click the first one. It's bringing me to a sub web page that is talking about plus 100, the feature. We go on the bottom. Go down, we see all the internal units, the part numbers, the sizes, the characteristic, how to install it, but we go here in the bottom of the page. You see we are in the bottom. I cannot go under. And we have door entry system configurator. And from here you can download your diagram software as well. Now, let's go to Door Entry System Configurator. Okay, we'll take a while because I'm uploading the web page and downloading everything to you. Okay, this is the first page. We have two options, single or double house. The single and double house, the common one, or the condominium. Let's do an example with the single house. Single house being single villa or semi-detached villa. Semi-detached villa could be the two floors villas as well. Let's go over the single villa. Always the system asks how many entrances you have, because you have for sure the main entrance that is already by default giving you the video. And then it's asked you, do you have as well a backyard gate or a second gate? Where do you need an external panel? You say no, we have only one main gate. So we say confirm and continue. We have the most simple solution, that is a kit, because it's recommending us to use a kit. We have different kit here, so we can choose any with the different characteristics. So it's sending us directly on the instruction sheet of the kits. And the work is done because it's one per month. Now, if instead to be one apartment R2, it will give us the possibility to use a double kit. So where you need to add the second unit. But let's try the most common one. So instead you go to the villa, let's do the condominium. Open again. Okay. Okay, perfect. So let's go with the condominium because we have more choice here. Condominium. Let's do the example of the one that we have 95% of the time. Building one block. Again, is asking how many external panels do you have? One on the main gate. The main gate, if it's in a city, they don't have the main gate, is the main door. So think always this gate is the main door. And then a secondary one, because in some cases you have a double entrance. Or maybe you have the gate for the car in addition and the gate for the pedestrian. So let's put the video as first, and we put an additional one video. Confirm and continue. We have to say how many apartments there are in the buildings. In the building, sorry. A common number is 10. So let's go to 10. We have some limitation because the common size of the building, it's around 10 apartments in Europe. So we put a limit now, I don't remember exactly, but it should be 50 internal units. That is already a lot. And it gives you, you can cover with these tools, really 95% of the cases. probably more. So I think more than enough. Then for the specific rules. So we say two external panel, 10 internal units. Now it says building first block. Do you have a driveway, garden where you need the lights? Or do you have a vehicle entrance without entrance panel? So probably we need an actuator that gives the possibility to open the second gate. Or you will have an interface for a CCTV camera, staircase lighting again, because you can switch it on from the internal unit as well. Pedestrian entrance without entrance panel, we don't have because we already put another one. Lighting combined with an entrance panel, so it means at the moment that someone ringing, you switch on the light, or additional camera. We don't have nothing now of this. Let's go to the second step. You see the first step are here, right? The main step, and then we have sub question inside. So let's go to the second step where we choose the components inside first our external panel. This part will take a bit because I have quite low internet speed. Okay, so let's start with what kind of external panel. We have two choices, that is by default Sphera modular or Linea 300 Van der Poel. Linea 300 is monoblock, so it means it's one per number with camera, push button, or digital. You can see that if we select this one, then you can go inside and say, I want stainless or I want aluminum. And then after this, I can go and say, I want digital core. And installation type as well. It's flash mounted or it's wall mounted. Flash mounted, any accessories, in this case there's no accessory. And this is the first external panel. Now let's go to the second. To the second one, let's use the default. We have Sphera modular. Which color? All metal. Yes, the most sold, the most simple. But we can have as well the other colors or the robot that is the vandalproof. As well, we have the possibility to integrate a speaker inside a third party push button because maybe you are in a city, they want a brass solution and you can integrate our. Then let's go to the camera. By default, we have the audio video wide angle under 35 degrees. That is the most sold. There is integrated the speaker. This one we can also select the 190 degree. And night and day one. Remember, night and day is a separate module where you have to add the speaker. It will be added automatically if you select this solution. We go with the standard one. Perfect. Now, class, we go to the internal units. Remember, we select 10 flats. Internal units, we have three options. Class 100 range, class 300 range, and Sprint L2. Sprint L2 is the cheapest audio. Class 300 is the 7-inch screen available in two colors or 12 colors. Desk mopping. last 100. So I have a hearing someone that opened the. Sorry. Can you check your microphone? Okay. So for class 100, we have always the choice between Wi-Fi, video without Wi-Fi, the regular one, and audio. You see, audio, you can have headset or handset. And for both, you can have already the desk mounting. Video. We have the basic one, the one with the additional four push button, if you need intercom, or if you need to control additional feature that you cannot control with the built-in push button, both in the desk mounting version, that is an accessory. So let's say that now we want 9 pieces of the basic, because we decided to put 9 pieces inside. Okay, 9 apartments will have the basic one, and we have one penthouse where they want the Wi-Fi version. So now we have 1 plus 9. Then you can even mix, you can put some apartment with class 300. Then this, we can go ahead. We have the list. Now I took 10 minutes probably to explain all the process, but you can see that in really 2 minutes you can have the list done. Now we have a list that you can see over the video with deeper numbers divided by external part, interest panel one. We have the linear 300 stainless steel, the first. Then we have the second interest panel, sphere with push button. And then internal units, the accessories, is the power supply, cabling, electronic accessory, flow shunt, and the configurator. By default, the system have the configurator. We can as well add, if you want, additional configurators, or we can choose to have the configurator kit, because maybe we want to have all the numbers to be in a safe site. We add the kit. We need something for the cabling, additional floor shunt or amplifier or line terminator. We can select them. Cable and connectors. Don't forget to add the cable if you need the cable, the 2-wire cable to connect everything. Access control. Do we need the badges, because we want to give the access control to the tenants? We can choose as well the color. In this case, now I can show you how I can go back, because for example, now I remember that over one external panel, I want to have the access control. So I can go back directly to customize interest panel. I have my sphere, where maybe I didn't select everything. I decided I have push button call double, or I can have a digital call with graphic display. I can modify something. And installation types, flash mounted as well. Do we need accessories? We want to put the badge reader. Yes, let's put a badge reader. And we can say, okay, right, we have 10 internal units because we didn't touch anything here. We go back to the summary, and in the summary, we have the proximity reader and the proximity reader from cover. So it gives you everything. Now, access control, I want to add some badges. Ooh, I don't know why changing the screen below. Okay, you see, I add some in some different colors. Now it's a bit late to update, but we add it. In fact, we have this accessory here, you see, a black transponder, red transponder, green. I put some colors. Okay, how to have the list now? So we can send the quotation here to send the recipient to the node, or what you always do is export in CSV. It is a text file you open with Excel. Before to export, we can have as well material list with the picture that is very useful because it shows you exactly what is every part number. Reading the details because you see as well the configurator one with the picture of configurator one. You have all the product you select, all. You can print it. Maybe you can print in PDF. So you can have a PDF. System overview. What it gives you, the system overview, it gives you a full list of items divided in list of materials, summary, standard panel one, standard panel two, internal unit in the building one, accessories. And then it shows you as well the cabin. So standard panel, power supply, that in our case would be one product because there is the new power supply, but the cabling is the same. We have two external panels, sorry, because we have one on the main gate and one additional. And then it shows you the floor shunt and the configuration of every internal unit. It shows you, you can connect it in, out, or the way we select is with the floor shunt. So with the floor shunt, you have four output for each floor shunt. You can connect your product. And it's showing you as well the micro switch you have behind the internal unit, because for each line you have to put on. Remember to, as I said last Tuesday, to close the pipe, to close the tap. Just the micro switch keep on. If it's not the last in the row, you leave it off, off, and you put on only the last one. If there was some additional accessories, it show you as well the configuration here with the details, what does any configuration, what you change, and select the number, what it happened. Okay. Now, I came back on the video configurator, export CSV. You see, I download automatically on my laptop the file, I click it, it's opening with Excel. This is my Excel. And it's give you the message because the CSV is a limited file, just text. We have the part number, I make it a bit bigger. We have the part number, description, the quantity for each item. The only things we don't have is the unit price, because it's accessible to everyone. We cannot put a common price here. So in this case, when the retail, the contractor, the distributor has this list, you just have to go a very simple things. Is opening, is his price list that is over Excel. You do a simple function that is vertical lookup, and is searching the prices from the price list. Get the prices, put the total, and you can deliver the quotation with all the attachments, because you can send the Excel file with the PDF with the single products, and as well the PDF with the cabling. So I have to say that the system is super quickly, because it's finished. And if you don't go and select many details, even if you do it, instead to take 1 minute and half, you take 3 minutes, not more. And you see that the good things, you don't need to know deeply the system, and is as well checking the power consumption. So it's not giving you a solution with the wrong power consumption. So this tool is very easy to make the quotation. There are as well quite a lot of languages, and just to recap, let's go back and show you once again how much time we need without talk about the details, and show you the details. Then you can go into it. So we say condominium, building, let's put a single entrance. I want to show you how much time we need. We put 10 internal units. Let's make it simple. We don't have accessory here. Probably we spend more time here to wait that it's opening the page of the external units than the whole process to get the items list. I calculate yesterday is 20 seconds this time from my hand. So we have Sfera modular, we check all the steps, yes, all metal, with this camera, wide angle, function, flash button, normal flash button this time, flash mounted, yes, accessory, what we want to put, nameplate, write something, okay, let's put nameplate. Let's go ahead, now, we put class 100. I would like to put all the 100 ticks, all. Perfect. I select, summary, finish. You see, less than a minute and you get the list with everything. So it's a really fast system to get your quotation. I recommend you to spend 5 minutes, go over the video of Configurator, put in your favorites, and give it as well, this tool, to your customer, because it's so easy that everyone can make a list and no wasting time, or maybe you want to modify something, because you know, the nice thing is that if you use Sfera modular, you can have really a lot of optional and modification, customization, let's call it, So if someone wants to change, doesn't have to go back to you and ask you the detail. You, the customer can go directly and make a modification. You cannot save it, but you don't need, because you can enter and make it a new one. So for the regarding the video configurators, I guess it's everything. I hope that someone has question. And no, okay. I start with this. Say,
Simone,
yes.
There is a question I was answering, but maybe it's interesting. The client is asking, the software signal you if there is a wrong selection or a wrong accessory. And in that case, I was writing that it's even better than the other software that we have, because it automatically check, as Simone said before, the power consumption. And it's impossible for a user to do mistakes, because it's the software that automatically, considering the request that you did, to give the right accessory that you need.
Exactly. So you don't have to go back and adjust the mistake to find the mistakes. So I say, because there was another question, if it's possible to save it, no. Because otherwise, to save it, it means that we have to create a profile to everyone, where you have to put your username and password to have your dedicated storage, let's say. No, because we want that everyone can enter. Because, you know, if you start to put username, password, the people that are lazy, they don't want to do it, simple. Everyone can enter directly. Then, yes.
I see that you can have the possibility to send the quotation to your mail. And in case you can save by yourself the quotation on your laptop or on your computer.
Yeah, I see Hamad is asking about the LED, probably already replied. The camera, it's sold with LED, it's built in the LED. You don't need additional LED. Remember, it's a camera to see who is ringing at the distance of the heart, not to see who is in the other side of the road. Because, okay, if you want to see what there is on the other side of the road, the night and day is better, but we are talking about a CCTV camera in this way, so it's better to put a CCTV camera. We have to see who is ringing, so 1 meter far. Remember, night and day has infrared LED, because during the night it switch to white, black and white, so you can have a longer distance. If you have a regular color camera or the wide angle, that is not a sort of a CCTV camera like the night and day, you have white LED. So white LED is give you limited deep in distance. So you have 1 meter and half, 2 meter maximum, if it's fully dark. If there is already lighting in the road, you don't have any. And
Simone, I have two questions. The first one is, if for the RFID module for the access control, the client can use a third party access control system, or if he can use only the BTCino one.
No, okay, if you take the BTCino one, it's fully integrated. The pro and cons of BTCino one are Pro, one per number, everything integrated. You have the RFID badges, you set different colors, and the real nice pro that if you have 10 apartments, you can create 10 master battery, keys, let's call it keys, RFID keys. And for each master, you can have different slaves. So let's take the owner of the penthouse, just to make an example. He has one master key and five slaves. The master key he keeps in a drawer at home. At the moment that there is a cleaning lady, she lost her key. Or she is changing the cleaning lady, she's not bringing back the key, and he doesn't want that someone open the gate. He go with the master key, he don't need to call the contractor, go with the master key over the badge reader, is wiped. At that point, it cancels all the slave connected to the master key. He bring all the slave keys again. It passes after this process. They are rejoined to the master key, and what is not, it doesn't pass at the moment, they are canceled. So you can use only the one you reprogram. Cons is we don't have inside today a full access control system, a full access control system. It means have a database with the names, and you can cancel the single name. But if you want to do this, most of the time you put a dummy cover and you integrate a third party access control system. I have another question. I have a project using D45. Okay, D45 we don't have inside the configurator to open the door strike using the external panel, as the process is too short to operate the electrical start. I have been guided to use negative.
I answer by writing. Okay.
Exactly, because I don't want to go out of the topic of the day. But Michael, we have a reply for you. And okay, so sorry for the beginning, because we have this problem with the audio. I don't know what happened. Sorry again. Thank you for your participation. Next time we will try to be more organized with the audio, and we'll try better. But it was weird what it happened. We will have next Tuesday, so in 1 week at the same time, the webinar about the Sphera. So we talk about the details about the Sphera. And I always remind you to subscribe to our newsletter. If you go over bticino.com, you have automatic pop-up. If you close the pop-up, go on the bottom or on the top and you find newsletter, and you will receive the update. We send really few email, and if it's the case, check, because sometimes it goes inside the spam, so you see it, put it as not spam. Because we send the product info, the news, and usually we send once to twice per month, not more. Okay. Thank you again for the participation, and see you next week.
Simone, wait, there are some other questions.
Okay. Good.
There is Tamir is asking which kind of wiring devices are you using in your house. Maybe it's an out of topic.
This is light air European standard.
Okay. Then there is a request about
this. You should know which one it is. You should know.
Okay, then there is a request about the certificate. If we are providing a certificate for this training, not at this time. It's not expected any certificate. We are going maybe in the future to organize some more technical training that for sure will permit you to get a certification about it, the attendees. And about Sied is asking if we are developing any facial recognitioning, fingerprint, and some other function on the entrance panel. Sied, we are not at this stage, facial recognitioning, because we think that it's not yet a technology ready for the access control.
We think about fingerprint. We have a long discussion. We were thinking, and I have to say that today more and more the fingerprint reader is something less and less request. Because A, recognition. Second, if you're wearing gloves, that you have a problem. And last, today with this coronavirus, I would like to see you want go and put the finger over the place everyone is putting the finger. You say, yes, you have the push button as well. True, but the push button, you can push it using another part of the finger, or you can use something else. You don't touch the fingerprint, you have to touch. And so nobody's cleaning the external panel. That's why we're not trusting too much in this. Okay. If there's no other question, I say many people say thank you everyone, and see you next week. Goodbye.